Adam Hostetter with SAF Tehnika in North America. Thank you for watching today. We're going to do a comparison video with SAF's ultra-compact line of spectrum analyzers called Spectrum Compact. We have five products that cover 2 to 40 gigahertz in an ultra-compact form factor and touchscreen, so you have real-time insight while you're in the field. We're going to look at these versus the Tektronix RSA306B. This is a USB-driven spectrum analyzer. It has been on the market for roughly a year and actually has a range of 9 kilohertz on up to 6.2 gigahertz. Now, what we've done here today, we have a continuous wave signal generator that is broadcasting at 6 gigahertz, and we have our transmit signal heavily attenuated to drop down the power on it. If you look here, this is SAF Spectrum Manager software. You can use this to drive these in a real-time mode if you don't need to carry it around and have real-time insight, or you want to use a PC, you can do that. In addition to post-processing, analysis, and reporting, you can see here, I can see the signal. My noise floor, it's showing me down around negative 110 dB. And I've got a pretty good view of that signal there in the software. Now, if I move over to the Tektronix software, I'm on the same scale here, and I have my marker set at 6 gigahertz, and as you can see, I can't see anything there. Now, one feature that Tech does have here is a reference level that's adjustable. So I'm going to go ahead and see if I can improve upon this for the resolution. So if we go here, I'll go negative 50 dBm for my start. And here, because I know I'm looking for it, I can kind of see it in there. But there again, I just can't be sure because it's still kind of in the noise. Now what I'm going to do is see if I can make that even better. So we'll set my reference level at negative 80 dBm. And that does not improve upon it. So we'll get it recentered there, and we'll get down to negative 50. And now what I'll do is go ahead and change the output power on my signal generator. I'll adjust it up by 13 dB. So we'll switch this to 10 dBm. And here you can see, okay, so now we can finally see the signal here using the RSA. And as you can see here on the SAF side, we still have much better view of what's going on here, and if we had some transients or we had some issues going on, you know, below our target signal here, we'd actually see those, whereas with the Tech product here, there's a lot that you're going to potentially lose in the noise. If you're interested in learning more about these, you can visit our website at saftehnika.com or contact your favorite distributor. Thank you for watching.